right? So we have started simple equation chapter. We have recalled that what is the meaning of equation. Equation is that expression which is having both left hand side as well as right hand side. Bhi blurry aa rahi hai video. Chal. So then we learned that if we are having an expression in which equality sign is not there, that means you are having the expression like this. This is less than zero sign is there. That means this is not an equation. So the first concept under equation chapter we did that how to check whether a given number is solution of the equation or not. So we are taking one equation x plus 5 is equal to 0. And we have to check that whether x is equal to 3 is its solution or not. So we will consider left hand side. Left hand side is x plus 5. Replace x by 3. You will get it to be 8. On the other hand side, what is your right hand side? 0. So what you conclude? Left hand side not is equal to right hand side. Therefore, x is equal to 3 is not the solution. Note the solution of given equation. So this is the way to check whether a given number is solution of the given equation or not. This is the first type, first concept of simple equations, that how to check whether the given number is solution of the equation or not. Let us do more questions from this concept. Suppose we are given the equation 5x plus 9 is equal to 8. 5x plus 9 is equal to 8. And you need to check that whether x is equal to 2 is its solution or not. So you will consider the left hand side. This is equal to 5x plus 9, right? Replace x by 2. X ki jagah pe 2 put karo. This is 5. Your Raj Aryan, your copy you have sent, but that is incomplete. है ना? So whatever is left to send it today. 5 into 2 plus 9. So that means, and according to board mass, multiplication is to be done first. Some of the students, what they do? They do like 2 plus 9 is 11. No, first of all, multiplication. This is 10 plus 9 and this comes out to be 19. So, and what you are having in right hand side, that is equal to 8. And what you conclude? Left hand side is not equal to right hand side. Therefore, x is equal to 2 is not the solution of a given equation. So this is the first concept of the chapter in which we have to check whether the given number is solution of the given equation or not. I'm taking the second concept of the chapter. Under the second concept, we learn that how to form an equation from the given statement. Given statement से हम equation कैसे form करते हैं? This was our second concept of the chapter. How to form equation from given statement. How to form equation from given statement. This is the second concept of the chapter. I'm writing some questions from the same category. First is sum of 3 times x. Sum of 3 times x. 3 times x and 11 is 32. Sum of 3 times x and 11 is 32. It is a question that two things are to be added. What two things? 3 times x. Hanji, what is 3 times x? 3x. And 11. Dono ka kya karna hai? Sum. And this is equal to 32. So this is the way to form equations from the given statement. Right? So I'm writing the next one. If you subtract 5 from six times a number, you get seven. If you subtract 5 from 6 times a number, you get 7. Let us see. You subtract from ke baad wali cheez subtraction mein hamesha pehle aati hai. From 6 times a number, let us suppose the number to be x. 6 times a number mein se when you subtract 5, you got 7. Right? 5 subtracted from 6 times a number gives you 11. Next question of the same category. One third of a number plus 5 is 8. One third of a number plus 5 is 8. किसी नंबर को आप one third करो, that means उसका x by 3 कर दो. Number we are supposing to be x, उसका one third x by 3, and then plus 5, that means you are adding 5 and you are getting it to be 8. that will also go. Simply you can write 1 by x into 3, that will also work. Right? This is simple. ये 7th की book है. हमें चाहिए simple equations. पर इसमें है ही नहीं. चलो anyhow. So this is the second concept of the chapter. Right? Let us do one more example. Product of two numbers product of two numbers Product of two numbers m and n subtracted from 3 times their sum. Product of two numbers m and n subtracted from 3 times their sum. Subtracted from के बाद पहले 3 times their sum, that means 3 into m plus n. बना रही हूं product of 3 number, अच्छा gives लिख लो, gives 8. अब बनेगी equation. Product of two numbers m and n subtracted from 3 times their sum. 3 times sum, that is 3 into m plus n. इसमें से क्या subtract हुआ? M and n का product. Product means m n. And your answer comes out to be 8. So this is the second concept of the chapter, that how to form equations from the statements. Statement से equations हमें कैसे बनानी हैं. Third concept of the chapter is how to solve an equation. Third concept that we are going to start is how to solve an equation. What is the meaning of solving an equation? Actually, Anji, bolo bete, ipsa bolo. Okay, product of two numbers m and n subtracted from 3 times their product. Sorry. 3 times their sum. Product of two numbers m and n subtracted from 3 times their sum. 3 times their sum means 3 into m plus n. इसमें से सब्ट्रैक्ट करना है प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द नंबर्स यानी कि एम एंड एन एंड योर आंसर विल कम आउट टू बी एट. नेक्स्ट इज हाउ टू सॉल्व एन इक्वेशन. वी डिड टू मेथड्स, वन इज ट्रायल एंड एरर मेथड, अनदर इज द सिंपल मेथड जिसको हम ट्रांसपोजिशन मेथड कहते हैं. बट वी आर नॉट राइटिंग द मेथड, वी जस्ट सॉल्व द इक्वेशंस एंड इन द फर्दर क्लासेस ऑल्सो यू नीड टू लर्न द ट्रांसपोजिशन मेथड केयरफुली बिकॉज इट विल हेल्प यू इन द फर्दर क्लासेस ऑल्सो. योर नेम इज, आपकी भी कॉपी नहीं आई अभी तक, कब की है? आज रीसेंड कर देना हमें क्योंकि मेरे को आपकी कॉपी नहीं मिली. चलिए, सो सॉल्व एन इक्वेशन वी डिड इट विद द हेल्प ऑफ द ट्रायल एंड एरर मेथड दैट आई एम नॉट यू कैन से गोइंग टू डील विद. यू नो ट्रायल एंड एरर मेथड, पुट द नंबर आंसर जीरो देन सॉल्यूशन बन गया, नहीं तो नहीं. ठीक है, हम जो है सिंपल इक्वेशन को सॉल्व कैसे करते हैं ये देखेंगे. वट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सॉल्विंग एन इक्वेशन. इफ आई से यू सॉल्व द इक्वेशन x plus 3 is equal to 5, it means to find the value of x. If I told you solve the equation y plus 2 is equal to 9, it means to find the value of y. If I say you solve the equation t plus 6 is equal to 6, it means to find the value of t. That means solve an equation means to find the value of the variable which is involved in the equation. किसी भी इक्वेशन को सॉल्व करने का मीनिंग होता है कि उस इक्वेशन में जो वेरिएबल हमारे पास बैठा हुआ है उसकी वैल्यू को फाइंड करना. व्हेन यू आर एबल टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ दैट वेरिएबल व्हिच इज इन्वॉल्वड इन द इक्वेशन दैट मींस यू हैव सॉल्वड द इक्वेशन. सो वी स्टार्ट विद द सिंपल क्वेश्चंस एंड देन चलिए फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन आई एम टेकिंग. सॉल्व द इक्वेशन पी प्लस 4 इज इक्वल टू 15. इस इक्वेशन को सॉल्व करने का मीनिंग क्या होगा? p की वैल्यू फाइंड करना. एंड जिसकी वैल्यू फाइंड करनी होती है बच्चे, लुक एट द बोर्ड, यू हैव टू मेक इट अलोन. आपको उसको अकेला करना है. दैट मींस आपको p को अकेला करना है. सारे इसको छोड़ के चले जाएंगे, बेचारा अकेला रह जाएगा. 4 जो है वो p को छोड़ के जा रहा है उधर. कुछ बच्चे क्या करते हैं, जब 4 p को छोड़ के आ रहा है कुछ बच्चे इसको भगाई देते हैं. आपके घर पे कोई आता है भाग जाते हो घर से? नहीं ना. सो अगर 15 के घर पे कोई आ रहा है 15 भागेगा? नहीं. इट विल बी एज इट इज. प्लस 4 शिफ्ट ऑन दिस साइड विल बिकम माइनस 4. धीरे धीरे पी को अकेला करना ही हमारा टारगेट है. नाउ दिस इज 15 माइनस 4 एंड इट विल गिव यू 11. नेक्स्ट आई एम डूइंग suppose x minus 5 is equal to 9. Solve the equation x minus 5 is equal to 9. Solve this equation means to find the value of x. That means to get this x alone. हाँ जी, क्या step होगा first? X is equal to 9. माइनस 5 शिफ्ट ऑन अनदर साइड बिकम प्लस 5. जिस बच्चे को इस रूल का नहीं पता कि दैट द नंबर व्हेन इट शिफ्टेड साइड द साइन गेट चेंज, उसके लिए प्रॉब्लम जो है वो हो सकती है. तो प्लीज इस रूल को अपने दिमाग में रखिए दैट हाउ टू सॉल्व. हां जी गौरीश.
यस मैम, जो आपने फोर्थ जो साइड पे आपने मैम ये एक सम लिखा था प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू नंबर्स, तो मैम उसका जो आपने रिजल्ट निकाला था, तो मैम उसके आगे हमने फर्दर उसको सॉल्व करके दिखाना कि 3mn माइनस.
नो 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 नो, जस्ट लीव इट हियर ओनली.
ओके,
यहीं पे छोड़ दो एक्सप्रेशन. राइट, सो यू आर हैविंग x इज इक्वल टू 14. लेट अस डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. Third question I'm taking. Suppose we are having. धीरे धीरे हम कॉम्प्लीकेट करेंगे. अभी अभी सिंपल सिंपल है ना. अब मैं लिखने लगी हूँ y upon 2 plus 7 is equal to 9. y upon 2 plus 7 is equal to 9. We have to get this y alone. That means first of all plus 7 will shift to the another side. And 9 will as it is plus 7 comes here will become minus 7. So you will be having y upon 2, 9 minus 7 is 2. right? So y is equal to, this is 2. Now see, this 2 is in division. Look at the board. This 2 is in division. And when will it will shift on another side, it will become multiply. Plus and minus, they are inverse function of each other. When plus shift to another side become minus, when minus shift on another side becomes plus, when divide shift on another side become multiply, and when multiply shift on another side become divide. Remember this thing. Let us do the next question. Next question. Three m upon 5. This is equal to 6. 3m upon 5 is equal to 6. To solve this equation means to find the value of m. ठीक है? So हमें m को find करना है. First of all, this 5 will shift on the other side. 5 इधर divide में उधर जाके क्या हो जाएगा? Multiply. Division 5 shift on other side will become multiple multiplies 5. So this is 3m equal to 30. 3 and m के बीच में कौन सा sign? Multiply. So it will goes to another side will become divide. M comes out to be 10. Now we will make it a little more complicated. Step by step we are shifting. Fifth problem I am taking. 4p minus 2 is equal to 18. So solve this equation means to get the value of p. So first of all, we have to separate this p. P needs to be get alone. So minus 2 shift on the another side will become plus 2. So 4p is equal to 20. Hanji Raj Aryan, next step. P is equal to, 1 minute. P is equal to, बोलो क्या आएगा? 20 upon 4, so P is equal to 5, right? Slowly and gradually, simple to complex questions we will do so that you come to know about how to solve these. I'm taking the next question. A upon 5 is equal to 7 upon 15. A upon 5 is equal to 7 upon 15. Solve this equation means to get the value of A. 5 is in the denominator, that means division. Udhar jaake kya ho jayega? Multiply. 5, 3 is 15. So A is equal to 7 upon 3. This is answer. Right? Next question. Twenty p upon 3. Is equal to 40. 20p upon 3 is equal to 40. We want to solve this equation, that means we want to find the value of p. So divide 3 comes on the another side will become multiply 3. This is 120. Right? So p is equal to 120 multiply ka 20 idhar aayega, kya ban jayega? Divide. So P is equal to 6. And sometimes in exam, it can also be said that solve and check. Solve and check. So apne solve kar liya, then you will make one heading checking. You will make one heading, that is checking. And how to check, let me tell you. whatever answer you are getting, you have to put in the left hand side and you have to see whether it is equal to right hand side or not. So I'm considering left hand side of your, this is 20p upon 3. Put kar do value, p comes out to be 6. So humne p ki value 6 put kar di. After solving, you get it to be 40. And what is your right hand side? What is your right hand side of this equation? 40. So you will write left hand side is equal to right hand side, hence checked. Left hand side is equal to right hand side, hence checked. Next question. Vs is equal to 0 and we have to solve this equation. That means we have to find the value of S. Hame S ki value find karni hai. Haan ji Savya?
Yes ma'am. Ma'am, jo ek aapne pehle question dala tha, A by 5 is equal to 7 by 15. Ma'am, uski ek checking kaise hogi? Bari wo bata do.
Okay. The question was A by 5 is equal to 7 by 15. Hamara iska answer aya tha 7 by 3. This was the answer. We need to do its checking. Chaliye, let us do. So I'm making the heading checking. So considering the left hand side, this is equal to A upon 5. Putting the value of A, A is 7 upon 3 upon 5. This is the sign of division. One number over the another number, sign of division. And you know, whenever sign of division, it shifts into the multiplication, things get reciprocal. 5 upon 1 will become 1 upon 5. So that will be 7 upon 15. And that is also the right hand side, hence checked. Hope, Savya, it is clear to you.
Thank you, ma'am. It is clear.
IPSA is asking that if after getting the solution, your while checking, left hand side is not equal to right hand side, so should we write hence no check? No, you have find out the solution of the equation that must satisfy the equation. For that, left hand side and right hand side should have to be equal. But if by chance they are the left hand side and right hand side not come out to be equal, they're not identical, what to do? Two things you have to do. First of all, check your calculation in checking. कि आपने चेकिंग में कोई गलती तो नहीं की. सपोज इन चेकिंग यू डिडंट फाइंड एनी मिस्टेक, देन गो टू सॉल्यूशन. देयर माइट बी सम मिस्टेक इन सॉल्यूशन, बिकॉज़ इसको बच्चे क्या करते हैं, धक्के से इक्वल कर देते हैं लेफ्ट हैंड साइड को. शायद नहीं भी आ रहा होता ना, उनको लगता है कि मैम ने कौन सा देखना है. लेफ्ट हैंड साइड 4 आया, राइट हैंड साइड भी फटाफट से 4 लिख के लिख देते हैं लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इक्वल टू राइट हैंड साइड. धक्के से इक्वल नहीं करना, इक्वल आने जरूरी है. इफ इट इज नॉट, चेक द कैलकुलेशन. फर्स्ट इज फॉर चेकिंग एंड देन फॉर solution. You must be find some mistake if such condition occurs. Is it okay? Chaliye. Next. Okay, I was taking the next question. Ts is equal to 0. We want to find the value of s from here. Okay? Keeping s with you, 3 is in multiplication with s. And on the other hand side, it will get divided. And some of the students, they write it answer, its answer to be 3. 0. 0 divided by anything is coming out to be 0. So these are the simple equations. So next of your exercise, it is containing more equations. That means a little complication in the solving equation. So let us start. Some more questions. Next question. Solve 4 into m plus 3 is equal to 18. 4 into m plus 3 is equal to 18. And you know what Bodmer says? Bodmer says, first of all, you have to open the bracket. So, pehle hum in brackets ko kholenge. And before opening the bracket, you have to match up the sign. Plus, 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 this is 4m. Plus, 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 this is 12. This is equal to 18. 4m plus 12, this is equal to 18. What you need to find? M. So, plus 12 shifts on the another side will become minus 12. So 4m, this is equal to 6. So m is equal to 6 upon 4. So m is equal to 3 upon 2. So whenever such kind of question is there, when the bracket is followed, you first open the bracket and then find the value of the variable. Firstly, you need to open the bracket. Next. Minus 2 into x plus 3 is equal to 8. Minus 2 into x plus 3, this is equal to 8. Again, firstly, you have to open the bracket. And for opening the bracket, multiplication is needed. But before multiplying, you have to match up the signs. Plus minus minus 2 into x, 2x. ठीक है? Plus minus minus 2 into 3, 6. ठीक है राजारेन, ये step clear है? अच्छे से देखो. पहले sign match हुआ, फिर multiply हुआ. Is it okay? Now, minus 6 shift on another side will become plus 6. Agree? So now, minus 2x is equal to 8 plus 6, 14. 8 plus 6, that is equal to 14. Now you need to find x, minus 2 and x. Kuch bache kya karte hain? Minus 2 udar gaya, plus 2 ho gaya. No, bete. You have to see the sign of this constant with which it is attached to x. Iska apna sign minus 2 ka hai. But ye x ke saath kaun se sign ke saath attached hai? Multiply ke sign ke saath. It is attached with x with the sign of multiplication. Right? Minus 2 udhar jaake plus 2 ban jayega. Ye nahi karna. Kyunki ye uska apna sign hai. But wo x ke saath kaun se sign ke saath attached hai? Multiply ke saath. Isliye udhar jaake ye ho jayega divide. So this is 2 7s are, ठीक है? 7 आ गया, नीचे minus है, तो answer क्या आएगा? Minus 7. Had it been like this, minus 2 plus x is equal to 14. यहाँ पे multiply है ना, तो मैंने इधर जाके divide कर दिया. Had it been like this, minus 2 plus x is equal to 14, then we shift minus 2 as plus 2. क्योंकि इस case में ये x के साथ, कौन से sign के साथ attach है? Plus के साथ. फिर इसको अपने साइन के अकॉर्डिंगली शिफ्ट करना, ठीक है? नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. एंड समटाइम्स इट इज आस्क्ड टू यू दैट आल्सो चेक, सो अकॉर्डिंगली यू हैव टू देन चेक आल्सो. अच्छा, इसमें हम चेक करते हैं. लिसन, आई एम चेकिंग इन दिस सॉल्व एंड चेक. मान लो ये क्वेश्चन है जो हमने पीछे, इसको ही कर लो चाहे किसी को, इसको करते हैं, दोनों को करते हैं. पहले मैं इसको करने लगी हूँ. M is 3/2. आपको मान लो पेपर में क्वेश्चन आया सॉल्व एंड चेक. आपके पास M की वैल्यू आई. नाउ यू विल मेक द हेडिंग ऑफ चेकिंग. दिस इज चेकिंग. टेक योर लेफ्ट हैंड साइड. दिस इज 4 इनटू M प्लस 3. रिप्लेस करो वैल्यू M की. कितनी वैल्यू M की? 3/2. पुट कर दो M की जगह पे 3/2 प्लस 3. So first of all, you will solve the bracket. This is 4. 2 is the LCM. 3 plus 6. This is 4 into 9 upon 2. And this is your 18. So left hand side, it comes out to be 18. After putting M is equal to 3/2, taking the LCM, solving, you're getting it to be 18. And what is your right hand side? That is also 18. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. Hence, चेक. अभी अभी जो हमने रिसेंटली क्वेश्चन किया था, लेट अस चेक दैट आल्सो. दैट वाज माइनस टू इनटू एक्स प्लस थ्री. दिस इज इक्वल टू 8. This was the question, and from here we are getting x to be, हमने इसको सॉल्व किया था और हमारा x माइनस 7 आया था, राइट? x वॉज माइनस 7. तो फॉर दिस वी आर गोइंग टू चेक, वी आर गोइंग टू कंसिडर द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड एंड रिप्लेसिंग x बाय माइनस 7. लेट अस कंसिडर लेफ्ट हैंड साइड. दिस इज माइनस 2 x प्लस 3. पुट कर दो वैल्यू x की जगह पे माइनस 7. ब्रैकेट सोल्व करो पहले. प्लस माइनस माइनस 7 में से 3 गया 4, बड़ा 7 है साइन माइनस. माइनस माइनस प्लस 4 टू जा 8. सो यू आर गेटिंग लेफ्ट हैंड साइड टू बी 8. आपके पास लेफ्ट हैंड साइड का आंसर कितना आ गया? 8. एंड व्हाट इज योर राइट हैंड साइड? योर राइट हैंड साइड इज आल्सो 8. सो द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड दिस इज इक्वल टू राइट हैंड साइड एंड हेंस चेक. So checking is equally important. How to do checking, you should know. Right? Next question. थोड़े से और complicated questions अब हम उठाएंगे. Let us take. चलो, we'll continue tomorrow. Revise exercise 4.1, 4.2. See you all of you.